I mean, you can be successful from just reading your books. Mm-hmm. And I keep feeling like that's like the next step, you know, like what you said, you know, charge whatever, $35 or $99 for a book. Like right. Noelle Randall, you know, she gets like, I think $900 per book she sells, because like she has all these extra markups. They looked back and just from that little book, but how does someone start writing? Cause I can't write to save my life. Like how?
Write. Yeah, that's a great question. Write. Take a conversation you have with somebody and transcribe, take the conversation and just transcribe. You know, getting background from you, John. Write like you're speaking to people. You could take a transcription of what we did here today at this meeting. Okay. And there's what's it called, Dragon, and all these other things. Apple has a built-in thing where you can automatically transcribe any audio recording. Take that as a template, a starting point, or an outline. Start with an outline. That's what I always do when I'm writing an academic book like Lease Purchasing or How to Sell with Guts. I'll write the table of contents first, the topics. And I'll just do 1 through 10. And then I'll just work on one chapter at a time. But write like you're speaking to somebody. But write the conversation, you know, don't try to keep it less is more in writing, in my opinion. You know, how many of us have bought guru packages and books, and they're full of, pardon my language, they're full of bullshit fluff. I've seen stuff where they're triple spaced, where they're using a 28 size font. And it's like, no, just less is more. Put content in there, succinct, to the point content. Add in role plays if you want. I do that in a lot of my books. I add role plays. People love that. Tell stories. Put your stories into the content.
So that's really got my wheels turning, because like I've done so many podcasts now where I on the Wholesaling Inc. podcast, where I interview my students every Friday. I have a case study that comes out. I guess I could probably turn that into a book right there.
Yeah. Edit it. Just edit it. Take out the things that are not pertinent and everything. And that can be very interesting. I did one book where I basically, the rule of guts here, and each one is about one to two pages of rules in sales. Simple book. I just wrote all the rules down, and then I wrote and explained each rule. And I'm going to make this into an audio book also. Same thing with another academic book, How to Sell with Guts. Started with basically mind maps and outlines on it. And then I took the mind map like an outline, and I explained all the different sections. These two were business novels. I like to write novels, stories, because I read a couple books, sometimes 2-3 books a week. I love novels. Okay. And what I find is I've always enjoyed business novels, you know, rags to guys ever hear of Horatio Alger's stories? They're rags to riches stories. Can anybody suggest any business novels? You know, I love stories where the hero has a tough time, and then they start learning by their mistakes. They either meet a mystical mentor or somebody like that. And I wrote these two books. I also have another one, A Lease Purchase Christmas Carol, where the broke investor is visited by three ghosts. Oh, thank you, Jessica. It was a fun read. I'll tell you a little secret. I'm even working on a Halloween lease purchase novel right now, a short story. Okay, where a guy goes into the house that is haunted by a dead real estate investor. Okay, and guess what? Here's the point. It's fulfilling a creative need if you like to write, either fiction or nonfiction, and you sell.